Let's talk about side effects. What are side effects? Side effects are outside effects that affect the function, or in turn, the function affects outside of itself. It affects the world. You'll look here that in the first two examples, we saw how the outside world could affect the internal. Pure versus not, the outside world could affect the calculation of math. Same input and same output is violated because of an outside global variable. Side effects here, we have a person, so we said, okay, fine, if we want to declare that dependency, let's do that. But this is where immutability comes in. When John Hughes says immutability changes everything, this is one of the core concepts of it. If we have a birthday and we get a person, we increment that age and return that person. And we're going to show you the world started like this. We ran the function. Did the world change or not? We log that person out. Did the person change? Did the world? This is just one variable. This isn't 50 singletons and Redis store, your local cache. This is literally just a variable. Run this. You'll notice that the person starts with an age of 18 and increases to 19 when we have a birthday. Makes sense. I was 18. I had a birthday. I aged a year. I'm now 19. But notice the world has changed after the function run. So it's not just the outside world affects internals of the function, but the function can affect the outside world. Obvious, I can set global variables of the function, duh. But this is a rule you need to recognize. If you follow these rules, you know if you're on the path of pure functions or not. So it's good to know these rules. Am I affecting the outside world? Do I have side effects? Do I have changes of variables outside of my current function? This one we do. We're mutating the objects. JavaScript objects and their properties are by reference. So we get this person by reference and change the reference even if we return it. So how do we get around that? We showed you how to get around global variables by declaring your dependencies as an input. Here's how you get around it by not affecting the outside world. You clone it or copy it. So we're going to use object assign, which you could also use the object destructor if you have a newer browser or a newer node version. We're going to take this brand new object and we're going to say, look, copy all the properties from person. It only has age. But take the age and increment it a year. Whatever it is currently, give it a year. Do the same thing we did before. We're going to start with a person age of 18. And we're going to say, this is what the world is now. We're going to run this function when they have a birthday and pass in our dependency, just like we did before. And then we're going to log the world again and say, did the world change after the function run? Did it affect the world outside of itself, to the side of it? Did it have a side effect or not? So let's run this and see what happens. We start with a person of age 18. The return value is a person who had a birthday. They're now 19. But notice we log the person afterwards and the world didn't change. That's because we didn't affect that reference or that variable we got. We didn't change global variables. We didn't call a method on it that changes the global variables. We literally said, here's a brand new copy. If you were to have a birthday, this is what you would look like. That is how, using immutability, you guarantee you don't have side effects. Declaring dependencies is one step of the puzzle. If you want to have outside dependencies, they only come in through function arguments. The opposite way you affect not you, the function, trying to be pure, affecting the outside world, is that you don't mutate data. If you mutate it internally, that's fine, as long as it doesn't reference things outside. But if you have to give a change back to somebody, you return a copy or a clone of that thing that's completely different and modified. So it's okay to mutate things internally as long as we follow same input, same output.